أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا الحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله وبحمده بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله وحده الله أكبر هنيئا لكم يا عباد الله يومكم هذا فقد صح عن النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم أنه قال أعظم الأيام يوم النحر أعظم أيام الدنيا ويوم النحر هذا ثم يوم الفرد وهو يوم غد الذي يليه وهو بداية أيام التشريع التي قال عنها النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم إنها أيام أكل وشرب وذكر لله سبحانه وتعالى. Congratulations, my dear brothers, on this eve. This is Eid al-Adha. This is the greatest day of the year. As our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has told us, that the greatest day of your days is the day of Eid, which is this day that ends with the future. And after that, is the day which comes after that. It is called Yawm al-Fitr, which marks the beginning of Ayyam al-Tashreeq. The 3 days which follow Eid al-Adha are days of celebration and dhikr, tasbih and tahmeed and takbir, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam has admonished us. On this day, my dear brothers, the first thing that comes to mind when we mention Eid al-Adha is the sacrifice. We celebrate, we do our udhiyah, we show joy and happiness, and all of these things are Islamic rituals that we are supposed to show. Because it is min sha'a'illah. Wa ta'zimu sha'a'illah, holding Allah rituals in a high position, is a sign of iman, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. But very few among us reflect on the true meaning of sacrifice. And why do we celebrate sacrifice? And why do we celebrate the sacrifice of Ibrahim alayhi salam in particular? Without sacrifice, brothers and sisters, we will not be here today. Without the sacrifice of the prophets and the Sahaba, the word of La ilaha illallah not be all over the world nowadays. It is because of sacrifice that great goals are achieved. Ummahs that know how to sacrifice, and when to sacrifice, and what to sacrifice, are the ummahs that deserve to have a place under the sun in this world. Ummahs that know only how to consume, and how to take, but never to think of how to give. Never to think of how to sacrifice will never become ummas. Will never have their names written in history as great ummas. And indeed, the greatest of all ummas, of all nations, is one man, Ibrahim. Allah says, Inna Ibrahim kana ummah. Ibrahim by himself was an ummah, was a nation. And that is because of the sacrifice. You see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested Ibrahim again and again. Not one test, not two, not three. All of his life was a test. Not in one aspect of his life, but all aspects of his life. He was tested as a son. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him a father who was an enemy of Allah. فلما تبين له انه عدو لله تبرا منه. He gave up his own father when he knew that he is an enemy of Allah. He was tested when he has to leave his own homeland and his own people after they wanted to kill him. قال إني مهاجم إلى ربي سيهدين. He became a refugee without a homeland, without a tribe, without a family, even though he had a homeland. And he had a big tribe. And he had relatives. But he left all of that for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he became a refugee in strange lands. One time in Syria, one time in Egypt, one time in Jerusalem, in Palestine, one time in Hijaz, in Mecca. But that is how he spent his life for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested him as a husband when he told him, and as a father, when he told him to take his wife and to take his newborn babe, only a few days old, to take him, as he says, بِوَادٍ غَيْرِ ذِي زَرْعٍ, to the wilderness, to take him somewhere where there is no trees, no fruits, no water, and to leave him under the sun, him and his mother alone, with nobody. And she asked him, are you doing this as an idea of your own? Or this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to do? He told her, this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told me to do. She said, then we'll be fine. And as a reward, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala broke the spring of Zamzam that millions of people are still drinking from every year. And they will continue to drink from it until the day of judgment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested Ibrahim again. When that son of his, balagh al-sa'y, when he became a young man, he came after a long wait. And when he became useful to his father, Allah did not simply take him away. This happens to many of us. But rather he told him to slaughter his own son. قَالَ إِنِّي أَرَى فَلَمَّا بَلَغَ مَعَهُ السَّعِي قَالَ إِنِّي أَسْرِيَ إِنِّي أَرَى فِي الْمَنَامِ أَنِّي أَرْبَحُ. This tells you why we celebrate Eid al-Adha and what we are celebrating when we celebrate Eid al-Adha. We are celebrating resilience. We are celebrating obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are celebrating commitment to principles to win every time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts you through the test and not to fail. This was indeed the ultimate. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ هَذَا لَهُوَ الْبَلَاءُ الْمُبِينُ. This is the ultimate test. And he told his son, يَا بُنَيَّ أَنِّي أَرَى فِي الْمَنَامِ أَنِّي أَرْبَحُ. And the son told him, يَا أَبَتِ فَعَلْ مَا تُؤْمَرُ سَتَجِدُنِي إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ مِنَ الصَّابِرِينَ. فَلَمَّا أَسْلَمَ وَتَلَّهُ لِلْجَبِينَ. When both of them accepted the judgment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Iblis came to him. Iblis came to him and told him, what are you doing, man? Are you crazy? Is there a father who kills his own son? And Ibrahim stoned him, casted him away, and told him to leave him alone. And that's why we throw the people in Hajj when we go. Jannatul Aqaba, in three places where the shaitan tried to stop Ibrahim from doing that. When he was ready to do what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَفَدَيْنَاهُ بِذِبْحٍ عَظِيمٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replaced him, replaced that sacrifice, بِذِبْحٍ عَظِيمٍ, with a sacrifice that we do. And that it is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam to do on this day. Inna a'tainaka al-kawthar fa salli li rabbika wanhar. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam said, there is nothing of a good deed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes more on this day than spilling the blood of a sacrifice. That its hair and its horns and everything on it will come to intercede for you on the day of judgment. Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam did it for him and for his family, and he slaughtered another sheep for himself and for his ummah. This is the true celebration, brothers and sisters, to learn from the commitment of Ibrahim. That is why we remember him in every prayer. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ala Muhammad. Kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ala Ibrahim. Because Ibrahim is our father who gave us this name. Who was Allah to the Muslims? And Ibrahim is the one that we are ordered to follow his millah. Millat abikum Ibrahim. Ibrahim is the father of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And the patriarch, the father of many prophets. This is what we are celebrating today, my dear brothers and sisters. We are celebrating the combination of Hajj. Exactly like we celebrate the end of Ramadan, the end of fasting, with Eid, a source for joy. Because we have completed our ibadah. Today also, we're supposed to have the joy for completing the ibadah of Hajj. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enable those who did not make Hajj to make it. To open Mecca again and the Haram again for Hajj. So that Mecca will be like Ibrahim alayhi salam has prayed to Allah, فَقْعَلْ أَفْئِدَةً مِنَ النَّاسِ تَمْوِي إِلَيْهِ وَرْزُقُمْ مِنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَشْكُرُونَ أَقُولُ قَوْلِي هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ. الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. Do not forget my dear brothers and sisters, today that this is the day of صلاة الأرحام. This is the day where we congratulate one another. This is the day of making peace among the Muslims. This is the day of showing our children joy and bringing joy to those who are unfortunate. Visit those who are sick. Remember those who might be in distress right now. Do not let your own joy forget these people that they cannot celebrate. There are millions of Muslims in China and the Rohingya and in refugee camps in Syria and in Palestine and in other places in the world. We need our dua. And we need our support. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا يا مولانا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. ربنا آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. اللهم ارفع غضبك ومقتك عنا. اللهم قيد أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم أمر رشد يعز فيه أوليائك وأهل طاعتك ويذل فيه أهل معصيتك. ربنا لا تدع لنا في هذا اليوم العظيم ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا ميتا إلا رحمته ولا مريضا إلا شافيته ولا غائبا إلا بالسلامة رددته ولا ضالا إلا هديته ولا عدوا للمسلمين إلا أخذته وقصمته ولا أسيرا لهم إلا فككت أسره برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وكل عام وأنتم بخير.